mentioned this once before. I've been to war 3 different times. I never thought that I would go to war 3 different times, but I did. And it's sad. It really is. The third time I went was probably the one that affected me the most in my life. When we went to Iraq, the very next day I ended up going to a funeral. The very next day. And most of the men and women that died during war between the age of 20 and 25, think about their entire life cut off just about. And we forget about these men and women that serve a lot of times. I do thank God that we do have a Memorial Day so that we can reflect on it. To look back and understand that there were people who actually died for us. And you say, did they really die for us? In their mind, they did. They died defending what they believed. And we have to look back sometimes and understand that we can't take a lot of what we have for granted. Many men and women have died. I mean, if you put all those numbers together that you just saw, it's well over 100,000. 100,000 or more people. Now, those were people that served. What you're not thinking about is how many people that actually died in the war altogether on both sides. Think about those numbers. The innocent men, the innocent children, the innocent women. All those people that are a byproduct of war on both sides. And I've seen both sides of the war, and it doesn't look good. We're all families. We're just families trying to live our life, trying to support our family, and try to do the best we can on both sides. But we don't need to forget. We don't need to forget those that died. That's what Memorial Day is all about, is remembering those who died while serving in the armed forces. But don't forget that there were casualties of war, of people that weren't. I thought about, when I went to the funeral in Iraq, I thought about the person's parents. They were so young. And the thousands of men and women that now there's some children that they're not going to have a mom, they're not going to have a dad. You know, a spouse that becomes a widow at an early age. And some of you here, it probably happened to you, or you probably know someone it did happen to. And that's what war does. I mean, if there's anything that's worth praying for, it is peace. It is peace. Pray for peace. Because war hurts on both sides. Both sides, it hurts. So, I just wanted to say that. I guess you all know, by the way, I'm suited today, a private military.